Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. It's Cynic Alex, and today we got our second sneak peek for the upcoming Deadpool and Cable update. Now, I call it the Deadpool and Cable update because this new sneak peek kind of shifts the focus away from Deadpool and squarely onto the shoulders of Cable, which complicates things a little bit, and it's why I need to explain some things to you, but also makes things a lot more interesting. So in the first teaser, in the first sneak peek, just to remind you, we got, of course, the introduction of Domino and Deadpool as two new characters, which is awesome, fantastic. They, of course, can be related back to Deadpool 2. And then we got a pretty curious set of new armor for Cable, which a lot of people were confused by and just looks generally unusual for the character because we don't usually see him wearing what we saw in the teaser. We usually see him wearing some version of what we have in the game already, and it doesn't match the one that we got from Deadpool 2, so it's not related to the movie. It's in fact related to X-Force and a lot of comics that have been running since like the early 90s, and we're talking about a whole span of comics that have and runs that have kind of come and gone and have included tons of characters. We're talking a cast of probably over 100 unique different characters. So we can't just say that this is going to be an X-Force update because that's too broad and the umbrella for the X-Force is just too gigantic. But to boot, on the sneak peek number 2, we do see a new character there, and I'll get to who that is in a second. It's a villain, but we do see the X-Force logo in the top right hand corner. That is the indication that this is drawing, or hopefully it's the indication that this is drawing primarily from a 2008 run of comics called, of course, X-Force. And from that we get a lot of juicy potential content. But first, let's address the question that you all have. Who is the mystery man fighting Cable? Well, that's Cable. No, seriously, it's a clone of Cable taken at birth by Apocalypse and raised to be basically better than Cable, but he ends up being a bad guy, of course. And his name is Strife. And he basically has most of, if not all of, the powers that Cable has in terms of the telepathy, the telekinesis, moving stuff around with his mind. But he doesn't suffer from the techno-organic virus. He doesn't have something kind of trying to destroy him from the inside. So he is technically stronger than Cable, which is bad news for all you Cable fans because Strife is going to make things pretty difficult. He looks like Shredder from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, so that's really cool. But we should be expecting a new villain in the game, probably a blast type to match Cable, but he tends to favor hand-to-hand combat a little bit more in addition to the telekinesis and the telepathy, and he has some pretty cool moves in the comics, namely flying around in a giant orb. So I don't know, he could technically be combat, but most likely, like 99%, he's going to be a blast type. Don't hold your breath for Universal, definitely not Speed. But beyond that, there's a lot of potential new characters and uniforms that we could get, so I've condensed it into a few short lists of three major kind of X-Force teams that they could be drawing from. Now, some of these include Deadpool and some of them don't, so I am kind of still on the fence about where he fits in. He has been in some X-Force teams, but not all. Just to give you a brief explanation of what X-Force is, because it has an uncanny resemblance to the word X-Men, X-Force is basically a team of kind of like spies or secret agents or kind of assassins, and they're basically usually made up of X-Men, of course, but their rules and their kind of goals or mission objectives are usually much more violent than X-Men, whereas, you know, Professor X and his team are about peacekeeping and building relationships between humans and mutants. No, X-Force is like, this is a bad guy, we gotta go kill him, we gotta go eliminate the threat. So that's why a lot of the characters you're gonna see on this list recurring because of their natural talent for bloodshed. So the OG team for X-Force, which you probably recognize some of these characters from Deadpool 2, if you were paying attention, we've got Boom Boom, Cannonball, Domino, of course Cable, Feral, Shatterstar, and Warpath. Now, I don't think most of these characters are ever going to come into the game because they're kind of lame, for lack of a better word, like Shatterstar and Feral. Please don't hate me, fans of those characters, but I just don't see most of these characters ever making it into mainstream games like Marvel Future Fight. But if any game is going to have fringe characters like that, it is this one, looking at the A-Force and other kind of bizarre characters like Warwolf. As far as recurring characters that we may see from this list, I would single out Boom Boom and Warpath, because they've featured themselves multiple times in kind of later runs or runs that are more recent, which is good. And Warpath is also in the Gifted right now. Technically, Warpath is could be referred to by two people. There's Thunderbird and Warpath, James and John, their brothers. But the one we're referring to, Warpath, is James, the much more powerful mutant. He's got the tracking abilities, super strength, durability, incredible hand-to-hand combat. While I would like to see him in this game because I love The Gifted and I think it's a great show, he's a pretty generic fighter, so I don't imagine him being terribly entertaining as a player in the game, kind of like Drax. But nonetheless, I would like to see him. But that is the OG team, and basically the only kind of cool tidbit I can pull out of that for you guys, is that in one of their original, or if not the original, run of comics, they fight Juggernaut. And Juggernaut gets mentioned and it gets featured in Deadpool 2, so there's a lot of kind of patching, and they kind of take ideas from different runs of X-Force and put them together for Deadpool 2. So we might see Juggernaut, we might see Warpath, I don't know, in this kind of pseudo X-Force update. But there's more to get to than this. This is kind of the juicy part, the exciting part. One of the more recent runs of X-Force, which actually features that logo, it looks really bad, but believe it or not, it's from 2008, includes images that you've probably seen before of X-Men that look super badass. And this is from the Messiah War, or partially from the Messiah War chapter. But in this, we can see uniforms, potentially for Angel, which would make him Archangel, X-23, which is kind of like the badass black and gray, Wolverine, also the badass black and gray, and potentially also Deadpool with the black and gray, even though he's not in Messiah War. We could also be seeing new characters in Bishop and Hope Summers. Hope Summers being Cable's daughter. So all of those are potentials if this were to shift into kind of a Messiah War type of update. Strife is also part of that kind of conflict, so it does tie in and it does make sense there, although Deadpool is not featured from what I can remember in Messiah War. I think he's in one or two chapters, if any, but he's in red, not in kind of the gray that you'd expect from the other characters that are part of the X-Force. But Warpath is also in there, and we got some other characters like Wolfsbane and stuff like that as well. So there are other options, but I'm kind of, you know, going on a tangent now because there are just so many characters. Which leads me to the kind of last group that it could potentially be. And this is called the Uncanny X-Force, I believe, or Cable and the X-Force. And this one represents or kind of relates to the uniform that we've seen for Cable. The uniform is pretty unusual, but I was able to track it down. And this group consists of Cable, Domino, Dr. Nemesis, Boom Boom, Forge, and Colossus. And so that's where the connection between Deadpool 2 comes in, and also the uniform for Cable. So we could be seeing some new uniforms potentially for, well, a new uniform potentially for Colossus. That run of X-Force kind of related comics also features Bishop and Hope Summers. So again, there's a lot of crossover where characters exist in both instances. The final one I want to mention, because I would be kind of remiss if I didn't, and I know a lot of you guys are going to appreciate this, is, I mentioned it already because I was confused, Uncanny X-Force. There's just so many iterations of X-Force, it's kind of hard to keep it all kind of lined up in my head. But the Uncanny X-Force, the team up, you're going to love this. Archangel, Deadpool, Phantom X, Wolverine, Psylocke. This is probably the bread and butter. I've saved the best for last. This is probably the most badass team up that we could possibly get. So it's a long shot, definitely a long shot, but potentially we could be seeing three new characters in addition, of course, to Deadpool and Strife. We could be seeing, I guess, five new characters with Psylocke, Phantom X, and, well, Archangel's not a new character, but Deadpool. And then two new uniforms, one for Wolverine and one for Angel, turning him into Archangel. That is pretty exciting. I'm not going to reveal the powers for Phantom X. If you've never ran into this character before, you should look him up. He's very, very cool. But you guys already know what Psylocke does and why she's kind of a super badass. So yeah, deep down, my hope is set on that one. But it's not likely, just considering everything and considering where that original logo comes from for the sneak peek number 2. but I wanted to give you guys as much information as possible. I wanted to touch on the most likely speculation as far as teams go, so that if I'm right about one of them, it'll look like I still work at Netmarble, because I know you guys love to make that joke. So let me know what you think of the predictions of the brief kind of jumbled up history of X-Force that I gave you. Let me know what you think down in the comments below and who you speculate is coming to the game to follow along with the three new characters and the one new uniform we have confirmed so far. Subscribe if you enjoy the content and you want to support me. Hit the bell if you don't want to miss any of my videos. And of course, if you like what you see, I hope to see you again tomorrow. Hope. Take care.